different. There's a celebration of Wesak full moon, the Buddha full moon. Buddha was born, became enlightened, and died on this day.
On this full moon.
On this full moon. Not this day. So we celebrate Buddha today, or Manipapi.
Mani Padme Hum. Namaste, I haven't really said namaste yet. And Miten said it right away early on, maybe not everyone was here yet, but just that today we're celebrating the Vesak celebration, the celebration of Buddha's birth, enlightenment and death, which all happened on the May full moon, and that's what's happening today. So
it's a very auspicious day, especially for me, because just like Buddha, I was a little prince in my family, and one day I just left and never went back, just like Gautama the Buddha did. And
that's quite
a I'm not comparing myself with but it's a similarity, you know, one little similarity. But there's another connection with Buddha that was very strong for me, and actually it was the Buddha that brought me to Osho, because in my darkest moment somebody had given me a book, and the book was a collection of Zen, Buddhist Zen parables that Osho was speaking upon. And these particular discourses that Osho gave were put into this book. And the book was called No Water, No Moon. I'll never forget it. And it was a book on Buddhist parables, Zen parables. And there was one particular story in that book that switched on the light for me and turned me, gave me the courage to step out of the known and into the unknown. And it was that book that and that particular story. And the story itself is very simple. It's it concerns a Buddhist nun, and a Buddhist nun who's called Chiyono. And the story in the parable goes that Chiyono was collecting water from the well one moonlit night on the Vesak full moon. And on her way back to the monastery, the bucket broke. And it just so happened that the moment that the bucket broke, Chiyono was looking at the reflection of the moon in the bucket, in the water. So the moment that it broke, the story goes that Chiyono became immediately enlightened when she turned round and realized that her whole life had been focused on the reflection of the full moon, or the reflection of the real thing, and not the real thing itself. And the moment that that insight happened to her, she became enlightened. And that was my story too, because I'd seen at that point that all the music I was making in the rock industry, and it is an industry, was not the real thing, but it was a reflection of the real thing. Somehow in the back of my spirit I knew there was a real thing somewhere, and I thought that was it. But one day I turned around, and it's ironic as well that Osho was known as the Lord of the Full Moon.
Mm-hmm. And did you get enlightened in that moment?
It's not exactly the same as Chiyono's story, you know. There's a few. But I did actually...
Twists and turns after that.
I made a song back then, way back.
Somebody just asked what the name of the book was. It's
No Water, No Moon. It's one of my favorite books, if you can get hold of it. I think it may be out of print now. But if you want a beautiful book from Osho, No Water, No Moon is great, because when he speaks of Zen and the Zen parables, he becomes a Zen master, so it's really intriguing. And another one that changed my life back then is a different story completely, but it was From Sex to Super Consciousness. Mm-hmm. And Osho was also a tantric master, so this was a great doorway for me into my own basic energy and how to transform that. So this was a song that came to me regarding Chiyono and the full moon, and it Deva and I were singing it earlier, but I don't know if we can actually remember it, but we will try. This is a nice song. Okay. There's a full moon in the night sky, and it's lighting up my path. Such a bright light on this dark night, and it's lighting up my path. Blinded by the light, I stand in wonder. Such a blissful night, deep in the heart, deep in the heart of love. Deep in the heart, deep in the heart of love. There's a full moon shining in the night sky, and I remember a story I was told. A beautiful woman drawing water from the well. Gee, oh no. Blinded by the light, she stands in wonder. Such a blissful sight, deep in the heart, deep in the heart of love, deep in the heart, deep in the heart of love.
There's a song in the ashram when Osho spoke about Buddha. Something like this one.
From the smallest grass leaf to the brightest star, we are Buddha nature. We are Buddha nature. From the smallest grass leaf to the brightest star, we are Buddha nature as we are. From the smallest grass leaf to the brightest star, we are Buddha nature. We are Buddha nature. From the smallest grass leaf to the brightest star, we are Buddha nature as we are. Everything is a blissfulness. Everything is a blissfulness. Everything is blissfulness. From the smallest grass leaf to the brightest star, we are Buddha nature. We are Buddha nature. From the smallest grass leaf to the brightest star, we are Buddha nature as we are. And everything is a blissfulness. Everything is a blissfulness. Everything is a blissfulness. Everything is blissful. That state of gratitude that we find deep in ourselves that has nothing to do with external situations. Our feelings, our life may go up and down like this, so if we're just being grateful for when it's up there, It's not the same thing. When we're talking about everything being blissfulness, we're looking to find that state of gratitude for no reason at all. That's the point. That's why we're here. That's why we're meditating. That's why we're singing. That's why we're chanting the mantras. It gives us a sense of access into our Buddha nature, into a space where, as the Dalai Lama said, well, he said many things. What did he say about that?
I have no idea.
Nor do I. But I'm sure he said something about it, you know, like the Dalai Lama is pure gratitude, you know, on legs, really. He's just pure gratitude. And oh my God, just thinking about him, I could cry. It brings me to a sense of tears. Mm. This is a special day, friends, a special moment in time. We're all together. We're linking arms across the world. So many thousands of us right now listening to Miten talking some stuff that you probably don't want to hear, but we're connecting anyway. Okay.
No.
Everything is blissfulness. By the way, you see this baby? Look at this. Look at this. I have some people to thank for this. There's a guy called Chris Scott, and he fixed up my baby like nobody ever did before. And if it wasn't for my new friends, Vani and Len, I wouldn't have found Chris. So I'm really grateful to all of you three guys. You're the Holy Trinity today, you know. That's really great. Thank you.
And before we embark on our meditation, I just also want to say another happy birthday. We're not going to do too many happy birthdays because anyway, why not? So this is for Eva. Eva, your beautiful friend Melly said, please, please, please give all my love to Eva for her birthday. And we all do. Yes, because she's German, so we say Eva. And so happy, happy birthday. And thanks for being with us and being part of our beautiful Sangha over the years.
We're going to do the seven chakra.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we have to. So let's prepare for our meditation, friends. So if you have your candles, you have your incense, you're in your power spot, you're in your temple. Coming home. If you're sitting down, now straighten up your spine. A sense of intention. A sense of presence. Sitting, you're bringing your attention to the sounds in your room, around you, wherever you are, and to these instruments that are being tuned. So take a moment, closing our eyes now. The whole point is to slow down.
Relax your shoulders,
mm-hmm.
The belly, the jaw, and the mind.
You know, Dave is very perceptive in saying our jaw, because we hold so much energy there. So just take a moment, if you have your mouth closed, to open your mouth. Relax that part of your body. This is the area of the sixth chakra is the area of communication. Fifth chakra, sorry, David. So just opening, relaxing our mouth, opening our mouth, and maybe give yourself a little out breath and a sound of ah. A deep breath and then ah. Just relaxing your throat. Slowing down. Slowing down. And remember, meditation is not serious. We are connected to that inner feeling of gratitude and a smile. There are no smiles in seriousness. And our meditations are sincere. They're not serious. We stay with sincerity. Sincerity, we can laugh and smile and dance and play and sing and recite poetry. None of those things happen if we're serious. Serious is a worse virus than the coronavirus. So let's bring a smile to our being and be grateful. We chant them. Mantra together, bringing your gaze up to your third eye, your sixth chakra, with your eyes closed. Bringing your gaze up to that source of light, you can feel and sense the light there. That's your sixth chakra shining. Mantra is known as the cosmic yes. A cosmic yes.
Let's take a deep breath together. And breathe out. And a deep breath. celebration of the seven chakras that we are activating and honoring and showing our gratitude towards, starting with the first chakra with Om Mo and ending with the seventh chakra Om Satyam, and all the chakras in between, that each of them, each energy, the energy of each chakra being a vital part of our existence and of our human experience.
Thank you.
Deva with the mantra Om. Eyes open, just close your eyes for a moment. Just come home. And if you bring your gaze up to your third eye again now, you will feel the expanse of light that our meditation has brought into our beings. Straighten your spine as we sit. Deep breath.
Let's invoke the medicine Buddha with the mantra Teyata, Teyata Om Bekanze, Bekanze, Maha Bekanze, Ratsa Samudgate Soha. Sure, there's somebody who can post it in the comments for everybody. And Teyata is the name of Buddha. Teyata means it is like this. And Buddha is the one who knows that it is like this. Teyata, Om Bekanze, Bekanze, Maha Bekanze. Bekanze is the remover of the illness. Also the remover of the great illness, which is the illusion of separation. So it is a mantra that works on a physical level as well as on our main illusion that we are all afflicted by, most of us humans, that we are separate from, so we are separate. Ratsa Samudgate Soha, Supreme Healer.
The tambour in there.
By the way, while we're playing this little intro here, I also want to thank my friend who who arranged for this guitar to be driven many hours away, and he arranged for it to be back so far so we can enjoy it today. And he also lent me his own beautiful guitars, my friend Michael, who's actually sitting here with us today and he's off camera, but he's been meditating with us. Nice to have you, Michael, with us. Tiata reggae, reggae, man.
Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha.
Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha.
So we bring our intentions to any of our beloved friends or people you know need healing right now, apart from the obvious, the world itself and the people in it. But if you have any close friends, this is a good time to bring them into your consciousness and bring them into your song and give them your healing mantra. We never know with the mantras, they're like flowers, they have a scent. And we don't know who's gonna be attracted to that scent, so just send it out.
Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Tiata Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Tiata Om Bekunzi, Bekunzi, Maha Bekunzi, Ratsa Samut Kate Soha. Sa Samudgate Suha Tiyata Om Bekanze Bekanze Ma Bekanze Ratsa Samudgate Suha Tiyata Om Bekanze Bekanze Ma Bekanze Ratsa Samudgate Suha Tiyata Om Bekanze Bekanze Ma Bekanze Ratsa Samudgate Suha
Just a moment of togetherness and being connected in our Buddha nature all over the world right now, at this very moment, many of us, thousands of us. We are Buddha nature as we are. As we are.
So today we have a special event coming up in about 10 minutes or so. We've never done this before. It's a premiere on YouTube of a video of the Gayatri Mantra as we played it in Sydney it was even Valentine's Day, if I'm not mistaken. It happens in 10 minutes, whatever that time is for you in your country. Just the link is in the post on Facebook, it's happening on YouTube on our channel.
Yeah.
And it's, for us, it's beautiful because it's with a whole band, and we just love each one of the one of our family, band family, so much. There's Manoj, of course, who is every day with us with the Mahamrityunjaya mantra from Santa Cruz. He's every day online. But the others maybe you don't see so much now. That's Joby Baker on bass, and also some vocals, who has been extremely creative and really giving beautiful shape to our sound for the last few albums, with Miten's albums and the Deva album and songs for the Sangha and Deeper Light. So it's a way to be in Joby's sound spheres. And then there is Spencer Music.
Well, Spencer Cousins is our piano player. And you'll see on the video, Spencer has space to... You'll see, Spencer's one of the stars of the video for me, because he plays, it's live, it's just a moment in time when they had some cameras, and it's just the feeling of being present with all our beloved Australian Sangha down there, and to have all the band playing, with us on the tour was a special moment. So yeah, like David says, the musicians are sometimes in the background, but they are not in the background in the sense of how we create the music. Every one of us has the same responsibility. And when you see Spencer playing the Gayatri Mantra in such a beautiful way, you'll know what I mean. And on the drums, looking very, it's as a very simple kind of expression, but actually Miles Bold, our drummer, is a master percussionist. He's a true master. And he can play that quiet and that simple and that with that strength. And so Miles has become the heartbeat of the band. And and of course Manoj is Manoj, and beautiful beautiful Manoj. So enjoy the video. I hope you enjoy it. And Deva sounds amazing. She's singing it so beautiful. It's a nice moment. It's a nice moment. And it's ironic that it's the last time we played that piece with the band in the old world before coronavirus. Mm. And it marked a moment in time. And we haven't seen the guys since. After that night, we all went to our homes. Dave and I stayed in Australia for a while. Everybody left. So it's a moment for us to all to enjoy. And I hope you do too.
Yes. You have a few minutes to take a break.
Have a cup of tea.
Yes. And then we see you on YouTube. And see you tomorrow. And thank you and love you.